And joining us on Hot Copy, Senator Teofisto T.G. Gingona III is with us this morning. Good day. Thank you for coming, Senator T.G., on Head Start.
Good morning, Karen.
All right. First, how's your mom?
She's recovering. She's here in Manila already. We were able to airlift her to Manila. And although she's in pain, luckily she has no life-threatening wounds.
Okay.
So panay flesh wounds and broken bones. In pain but recovering.
Yeah, but recovering. Now, just to give an update to some of our viewers who may have arrived or may not know exactly what happened, your mom was ambushed on April 20. She is the mayor of Hingoog in Misamis Oriental.
Yes.
And I think two of her bodyguards died.
Not, those were not bodyguards.
Okay.
Those were just civilian employees. One was a driver and the other was a parang kasama, aid.
Oo. And tatlo lang sila sa sasakyan.
Three inside and then two on sa back. It's a pickup. It's a Toyota Hilux.
Now, do you know why that ambush took place? Looking back, why your mother?
Well, let's just go by the admission of the NPA that first, it's their fault. They said it's their fault. They take responsibility. They said because of the checkpoint that they had and they were their policy of not carrying firearms in their areas. Mm. So I think that would be, although there are a lot of other speculations.
Were they claiming it was a mistaken identity?
My mother has been mayor for 9 years. Everybody knows her vehicle.
Yeah.
There's no mistaken identity, and yeah. I don't know. I really have my doubts as to whether it was just a checkpoint or it was an ambush. Ako, personally, I feel it was an ambush because of the, it follows the modus operandi, plus the fact that everybody knew it was her vehicle.
Okay, now what do you think would be the NPA's motive?
That's something we keep asking ourselves. Why us? Why did you do it to us? You
know. Had they answered?
Their answer was the violation of the policy of not bringing firearms in their controlled areas. But I don't know.
You don't believe. Now, do you think it could be political in nature? Could it be that her opponent?
It's also possible. It's also possible because there are a lot of speculations. But to say outright that it's that, then I'm not too sure.
Yeah.
I don't have the proof to say that.
Okay. Now, as a sitting senator, what should we do about this as a country? The NPA has been tolerated for so many years.
44 years.
44 years. And let me just go on. If they ask a candidate 5 million to campaign in a rebel-infested area, it's crazy how they harass a company like Smart and Globe to put up a cell site. The NPA has bombed cell sites before if they will not pay certain fees. The fact that the NPA has a checkpoint, I mean, it's amazing that for so long, this has been tolerated. It's like there's another whole authority other than the PNP and the AFP.
Exactly. That's what I said in my press con. That, kasi they were saying that it's their violation of their policy. But teka, sabi ko, magklaruhan tayo. There's only one government here in the Republic of the Philippines. And that government is the government headed by the legitimately elected leader, Noynoy Aquino. And the only institutions that have the right to implement the laws is the Office of the President and the institutions under it, namely the Philippine National Police and the Armed Forces of the Philippines. No one else has the right to put up checkpoints. And therefore, those checkpoints are illegal. Those checkpoints are basically against the law. And they should be dismantled. No ifs, no buts about it.
They should be dismantled. The
no,
NPA.
So.
How should we do it? Clearly, now, there is a Bangsamoro agreement. It's one of the successes of the Aquino administration. But the NPA was, well, neglected.
According to Alex Padilla, the talks have broken down.
Okay.
And but it's my hope that they go back to the table because number one, it's been a long drawn out insurgency, and number two, if hostilities escalate, you mentioned SMART, you mentioned Globe. If you recall, recently there was the mining firm in Surigao.
Yes, in Surigao.
The killing of the security guards and janitors in Del Monte and Bukidnon.
Tama.
There is an increase of hostilities.
Yeah.
And as we all know, if hostilities escalate, nobody wins.
Yeah.
There will always be victims on both sides. Families will lose their fathers and children. Lalo na children and wives will suffer most in hostilities.
Yeah.
So I think it's to the best of all. After all, we're all Filipinos to end these hostilities and to go back to the negotiation table and come up with a true, lasting peace agreement. Because it's only with a peace agreement that we can move forward as a nation.
Because how would you find justice right now for your mother? I mean, you cannot charge them in a civilian court. They're a rebel group. How would you do that?
They did say sorry. They did say sorry. They did apologize. But again, if they would like to show sincere apology, then maybe number one is who are the culprits? Surrender them to the law so that they can be tried under the laws of the present government, under the laws of this republic. They have to show sincerity first.
Now, have you contacted any of them, or has anyone contacted you? I mean, the leader of the NPA, for example, in the Philippines. I'm curious, who would it be in the Philippines, the armed, when it comes to the armed?
Well, actually, wala pa naman. It's wala all pa. By media.
Oh,
it's all by media. Through the radio, through the television, that we hear the apology.
But you have not heard anything from, like, Luis Alandoni?
No, not from
nothing
that.
Like
not,
that.
Not from those who are abroad, no.
Okay. So, you're not expecting them to actually surrender the real culprits?
That is my answer to their saying sorry. Then I say, if you're sincere about your sorry, then surrender them to the folds of the law so that they can be tried in accordance with our justice system.
Yeah. Now, you've said we should go back to the table, but clearly that will take some time. I mean, you've seen how the agreement with the MILF took place.
Yes, it will take time, but we should never stop. It's only with a genuine peace agreement that we can end this conflict. When people start to respect each other's differences of opinion, you must remember, people have different views all the time. You know? Difference. People are different because of race, religion, ideas, and ideologies. And difference is an accident of humanity. Difference, I guess, is what John Hume said. In essence, this is the essence of humanity. The answer to difference is to respect it, and therefore, that's the fundamental principle of peace: respect for diversity. You cannot convince someone if you're holding a gun. Might does not make right, and they've been at it for 44 years. They're going nowhere. I appeal to them to go back to the negotiating table, just like what is happening with the MILF. Let's forge a true peace agreement so we can end all these needless hostilities and we can all move forward as a nation. We have so many challenges as a nation, and we have to face these challenges as one people.
Okay. Now, there's a good tweet here. It's from Dr. Tony Liachon of UP Manila. He asks, should we employ peace agreement with them like during the time of Magsaysay versus Hukbalahap Luis Tarok?
I'm not familiar with the peace agreement during Magsaysay time.
But I think using one of them, that's what he means.
Using one of the...
Coming from the rebel camp.
Uh-huh. I'm not too clear what he means, no? But anything is worth looking into. By the way, I do agree with what Alex Padilla said, yeah. if we go back to the negotiating table, number one, it should be time bound. You know, it's from here to this point in time. Yeah. Hindi yung let's just talk openly. Number two, it must be agenda bound.
Okay.
Number three, there must be a cessation of hostilities monitored by a third party.
Okay.
So that if there are violations, then mm-mm. And
Senator, we have your mom on the line.
Yes.
All right. Okay. Before we take a quick break, Senator, I guess, what do you want? I mean, hearing your mom, I mean, it must may kurot sa puso, you know?
Yes, and she's very lucky, really. It's really a miracle. You know that they threw several hand grenades.
Oh, my gosh. They did?
Yes. And the hand grenades that landed far away from the vehicle exploded. Those that hit the vehicle directly did not explode.
Oh, my.
Isipin mo kung if that exploded.
Yeah.
Yes. And then several bullets passed through her. One bullet grazed her cheek right here. Can you imagine just a few inches higher what damage that would be? And then there was her biggest wound. Is she has a bullet wound here in her inner thigh.
Yeah.
And it came out here, sa buttocks, no?
Yeah.
And,
oh, my gosh.
According to the doctors, there's a major artery right behind her legs.
Kinikilabutan ako, yeah.
May that brings out the blood, no? And it just missed that artery. Okay? Now, what happened then was because of the blast and namatay yung driver, the vehicle turned to its side.
Yeah.
And it took several hours, I think around 5 hours like that. They were like that 5 hours. Every time they would move inside the vehicle, they would be hit by a hail of gunfire and grenades.
So, kumbaga, they did not stop. The NPA did not stop.
Let's be clear about it. The intent was to kill. And this was not just one bang. No.
Yeah.
They waited for every time there was a movement in the vehicle. You know, when my mother was looking for her cell phone to call.
Yeah.
So, when she was groping around, siyempre, the vehicle would move, the pickup. And then they would hit, rake the vehicle with gunfire again, and then after a while stop. So she had to play dead inside the vehicle for several hours.
Oh my gosh, yeah.
So that's how it was. And imagine if she got hit in any major artery. She would have bled to death because it took 5 hours more or less for the rescue to come.
Yeah, that is a miracle.
That is a miracle.
But hearing your mom speak and you, I am actually very. I mean, surprise, there is not this hint of bitterness or rage. It's more of a question of why, especially your mom, I think she's sincerely asking why I've served the poor well. I mean, I think what she wanted to add, but maybe didn't, hindi naman ako nagpayaman doon or nagnakaw.
Yes, yes.
And di ba, parang, ba't ako?
Yes, yes.
And you don't seem to harbor this, I mean, absolute rage.
Well, frankly, there are mixed emotions, but yes, we try to look at it in a more positive light and say that let's end this. You know, hatred begets hatred. So
wow. Okay.
Let's end all this violence because this was not the first time and this will not be the last time that there will be victims. And like you said, it's good if it's a mayor that will be a victim, or the mother of a senator.
Yeah.
It's not going to be like that all the time.
Exactly.
And I know how it is now, how painful it is. And therefore, what's more important is we try to make sure that this doesn't happen to other people in the future.
Mm-mm. Okay, your father, is he okay?
Yes, he's okay. He's at home. He visits my mom every day. So they're talking.
Oh, my gosh. All right. Okay. A very touching moment here, but we'll take a quick break. When we return, we'll continue our interview with Senator T.G. Gingona. Hot Copy. We'll be right back. Welcome back to Hot Copy. With us is Senator T.G. Gingona. We've always, the COMELEC has said the NPA is the biggest threat to election-related violence. And it never had a face until today. Today, there is a face to the NPA election-related violence. Now, remember there was a mayor that was interviewed who refused that his town, I can't remember which one, he didn't want it to be under COMELEC Exactly. Would there be a change if it were?
It just means that literally the Comelec is in control of the town. I really don't know what he meant by that, why he didn't want to. It's usually to the advantage, because sometimes when you perceive that the forces, the police forces, are biased towards one or the other.
Exactly.
Then you put it under Comelec control so that the Comelec can dictate already. The PNP could have been removed, replaced.
Yeah, yeah. Now, after this particular incident, your sister is still going to continue her candidacy?
Yes, they. By the way, today is Monday. This afternoon, they'll be burying the two civilian personnel that accompanied my mom in Hingwaog City. And they will continue their candidacy.
Yeah. How do you think should this, usually what happens in the Philippines is it hits the headlines, people are appalled, but then we forget about it.
We should not forget about it. That's why it's also the job of the institutions of society, media in particular, to keep up the memory of how this conflict is affecting the lives of people.
All over
the country. And on the part of the leaders, that we should never give up hope of being able to achieve a lasting peace agreement.
Yeah, because what politicians do, and I'll be honest, in a way to tolerate the NPA is, if they will go to a certain area and campaign, let's say it's a senator, what they'll do is their party will inform the NPA ahead of time, parating si senator ganun na, parating si ganun. So in a way, nagiging ano siya eh. Parang, you understand?
I understand. But you must also understand that people are people.
Yeah.
And people don't want to get shot.
Mm-mm.
And people will do everything so that they can secure their persons and their families. So,
mm-mm,
yung informing might be just out of the need to stay alive.
Uh-oh. Okay. All right. Lanao Mayor Manamparan, yun, siya yung may ayaw sa area of concern. Kasi para daw kinampihan ng Comelec ang gumawa ng karahasan.
Oh, well, that's another matter. Yeah, altogether. If the Comelec is the one that's biased, then that's certainly something else. No?
Okay. Now, are you satisfied so far? I know you're not running for 2013 without the Comelecs performing the PCOS. I know there are concerns with the security.
There's still a lot of issues, but the elections are just around the corner. I guess we have no choice right now but to continue and try as much as possible to make sure that the fears that have been expressed by certain sectors, which does have basis, the fears do not become reality.
Yeah.
And let's all hope and pray.
What was your dad like when he found out? I mean,
when he found
how
out,
how old is your dad now?
He's 85 years
85.
Old.
85. Imagine to be faced with this emotional trauma at 85.
I got the phone call at 11 o'clock in the evening. Up to around 5 o'clock, we didn't know what was happening to my mom. All we could hear were reports that there was firing. We didn't wake up my dad.
Really?
Yeah.
So you
spared
him?
We waited till he woke up at 6. He usually wakes up at 6. I called my brother who lives with him. When Papa wakes up, you tell him this is the situation, and you have to be there beside Papa. Don't leave him.
Yeah.
I'm leaving for the airport. I'm taking the first flight to Cagayan de Oro because of what happened. You know?
What was his reaction when he was told?
When he was told, which is around 6:30, luckily, the report was they already were able to rescue my mom.
Okay.
So
makahinga.
Yes. Uh-oh. So Papa, something happened to Mama. She was ambushed and all this, but she was rescued na. So yun, at least when he woke up, the horrifying news was tempered by news that she's safe and alive.
Yeah, because it must be so difficult considering your parents, I mean, are in their most senior years of their lives.
It is quite difficult, yes. And you know, it happened in an area where there was no signal, no cells.
Oh gosh. Kahit smart or globe, wala.
Kahit smart or globe, wala.
Honest? All right. Okay. Last word, Senator.
Well, might does not make right. You cannot you cannot convince people from the barrel of a gun. Mm. Difference, as I said, as John Hume said, difference is an accident of humanity. Difference is the essence of humanity. The answer to difference is to respect it. And therein lies the fundamental principle of peace, respect for diversity.
Mm-mm. What action would you want done after this? I mean, something specific. Has President Aquino, by the way, told you that he will act on it?
He has told us. Uh-huh. He visited my mother in Cagayan de Oro. The day when she was rescued, he visited her. And he did say that he would bring in the troops, so to speak. And the troops are there already. Mm-hmm. In Iloilo.
But he has not told you yet what he plans to do with the NPA.
Well, of course, he did say that we will do all that we can do to crush these checkpoints.
Ah, okay. Mm-hmm. All right. On that note, thank you very much, Senator T.G. Gingona. Thank you for coming to Head Start, as always.